Umesh, assistant lecturer at Chitkara School of Hospitality. And today we are going to learn about Introduction to Food Production Department. This chapter will enable us to understand the levels as per the hierarchy, skills and experiences of a chef or an employee of this department. It will also help us to understand the working methods, roles and responsibilities of kitchen professionals, the use of personal hygiene and clothing of a chef, and how to use the equipment safely. But before that, we need to understand what cookery is. So cookery is an art of cooking, and it is also known as cuisine in French. It is a chemical process which brings on physical changes or chemical changes to a food item. Heat application is also involved in cookery, which includes withdrawal and application of heat to cook the food or to prepare it. Decision making and technical knowledge are also a part of cookery. If we talk about the levels and skills of an experience of a chef, we should know that a chef should be motivational at all the times. He should be multitasking. For example, he should be able to cook different foods of different cuisine. He should be able to work in different levels. He should be able to work in different departments. He should also know how to give attention to the details of prepared food, and culinary expertise should also be a part of essential skills of a chef. Positive attitude is also a mandatory part of chef's lifestyle. We should remain positive at all the times of his shifts and off shifts. He should wear clean uniform and prepare food with all the hygienic standards mentioned by the hotel authority. If we talk about the attitude and behavior in the kitchen, it starts with positive attitude. Like, a chef should remain positive at all the situation. He should remain calm, and he should have a balanced patience. Staying power means he should be able to lift different loads or different type of items at different times. Then he should be able to work for longer shifts if required at some times. He should be able to work with different types of people. He should be able to communicate and be creative at all the times. Why communication? Because there are times when a chef might be required to talk with different guests from different A chef should also be experienced in a specific cuisine or in different cuisine. He should know how to take care of his equipments, and he should be able and eager to learn different abilities and different things at once. Going towards our next slide, which mentions personal hygiene of a chef. So it starts with hairs. His hair should be covered with cap all the times. They should not be untidy or well cut. Earrings, necklace and chains are not allowed in kitchen or in hotel premises by the employees. However, it is different for female staff. No outer pocket should be hanging, or no outer pocket should be visible in the kitchen dress. His dress should always remain neat and clean. Wristwatch are not required in a chef's uniform, or is not a part of a chef's uniform. Cover all the wounds properly. Nail should be trimmed and clean. That is, it should be dirt free. Then torn clothes are not allowed to be worn in the kitchen premises. And if possible, always wear safety shoes or clogs. Here in our next slide, we have a description of the chef's dress, also known as robe de chef in French, starting from toque or chef cap. We have another part, which is white necktie. But before moving to that, we should mention that chef cap is always required to be worn in the kitchen to avoid any hair fall on our dishes. Then we have white necktie or scarf, which is made up of antiperspirant or perspirant proof clothing. It is different for different levels. However, an executive chef is exempted from wearing a scarf. Then optional name tag of the company. Then we have vestibular or chef's coat, which is white, usually white in color, with black button and double chested or double breasted. Then we have dish cloth or a kitchen towel or a kitchen napkin. Then we have apron, which also helps us to keep our trousers clean, and in an incident of fire, we can wear it off very easily. Then we have checkered trousers, which do not look dirty even while we are working, and we have slip resistant shoes. Here is another example of a chef dress and the part of chef dress. Starting from toque, which is 100 folds, initially signified a status and worn by different chefs. Moving to our safety procedure in handling equipment, we have kitchen tool safety. Like, a chef should always remain available or remain knowledgeable about how to use kitchen tools very safely, how to operate electric equipments like chopper, blender, Canon blender safely. Then uniform safety is also an important part of chef's safety handling procedures or handling equipment procedure, because uniform should always remain clean, that is dirt free, and it also depicts the hygiene environment or the hygienic condition of a kitchen. Physical safety resembles that a chef should remain sickness free. However, if he feels he is sick or having some sort of disease, he should not attend his duties or inform his supervisor about his physical fitness. Food safety is all about hazard analysis and critical control points in a kitchen, be it biological, chemical, or external. So with this slide, we would end our topic for today. In our next topic, we will read about different types of cuisines of different countries. Thank you.